afternoon baseball here on the show. Ought to be a good one here between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Philadelphia Phillies. It's Phillies baseball next on the show. Aaron Nola starts the game on the mound for the third and final game of the series. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, this guy's done a real good job on the year keeping the opponent's batting average down. Both righties and lefties coming into this one, hitting under 250 against this guy. He's been good all season long.
Standing in, John Torres.
Leading off,
and we are ready for some daytime baseball.
The right fielder, number five.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Underway now in the Sunday finale as the game's first pitch is taken for ball one. Dan, D-Row, these Phillies, as they begin play here today, they come in not exactly setting the world on fire as they've dropped five of their last eight ball games.
135.
Yeah, Matty, be a hitter. So one thing they'd like to do here today.
Yeah, they can salvage a little bit right now. They can walk out of here today with a smile on their face. If they can get this back to 500 in these first six games.
Here's Colton Wong now. His past line against Aaron Nola. He's got a 3-for-5 line. First pitch coming. Here it is. Wong is a strong defender playing up the middle in the infield. He's got great hands, good range, the big arm, and those skills are not lost on his teammates, his coaches, or his front office for that matter.
Yeah, he has the ability. What I love about this ball player, he's got such a great internal clock. It seems like it's bang bang at first every time, but the guy's out. He's got sure hands and an accurate throwing.
Inside, as he might be trying to set him up here, 1-2. Our temperature should get us up into the 70s as we move along. 68 at first pitch. The 1-2. Gets him looking at the knees for the strikeout.
That is perfect.
And that brings up Paul Goldschmidt, swinging it well so far in this series. He's 3-for-9. Here it comes.
Ball one, no strike.
Two out, nobody on. A ball and a strike to the Cardinals' first baseman.
I know that fastball registered at about 92, 93, but I guarantee you it looked about 4 to 5 miles an hour faster than that for this offensive player. After coming off a curveball, the old push the throttle and pull it is being used.
The 2-1. It's a changeup that's looked at for a ball.
This is where you cash your checks right here. 3-1, you're one of the best hitters in the game. You live for situations like this.
Bases are empty here with two men out. And a full count to Paul Goldschmidt. Three balls and two strikes.
If the offense didn't already know, man on the mound's got his A-game fastball working today.
And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. Down in order go the Cardinals. So now the Phillies offense will see what they can do. No score. Miles Michaelis is on the mound for the Cardinals. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, Matt, this guy keeps his team in the ballgame. He's won two of his last three starts, so he's been throwing the ball really well. And one of the keys for this guy is getting early outs to keep his pitch count down. If he can do that, he should be able to get into the seventh or eighth inning in this one here today.
And there you see the leadoff man, Andrew McCutchen, as he'll start us out in the home first.
Center fielder, Andrew.
Now here it comes.
Okay.
And here's a slider that's nowhere close, and it's 1-0. Dan, D-Row, we take a look at this Cardinals ball club as they enter play this afternoon. They come in playing well. 6-3 over the last 9 ball games, including a victory last time out.
Hey, thanks, Matty. Hey, you know what, D-Row? Try to get on a kind of a little mini winning streak here. Losing the first game of this series, winning game 2, and hopefully winning this series by pulling one out here today.
Yeah, Dan, they were able to shower that first loss off in the first game of this series and had a nice bounce back game yesterday. Let's see if they can steal the series right now.
And that's in there, 2-1. Swing, high drive, left field and deep. And he's going to have room to put this one away, and that's the first out.
Batting second, the shortstop, Justin Turner.
Digging in now for Philadelphia, Justin Turner. And as you check out his righty-lefty splits, no surprise that he hits better against southpaws than he does against right-handers. Ready. Here's the first offering. Hit in the air to straightaway center. Bradley is there. Two gone.
Batting third. The right fielder. Parker.
Next to dig in will be Bryce Harper. He's yet to get into the hit column in the series. 0-7. Field shaded toward right center. Here's the first pitch. Off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone. Two out, nobody on.
Nope.
Up top, it's 2-0. Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0.
I'd be shocked if this wasn't a four-pitch walk right here. He doesn't want to mess around and leave something over the heart of the plate and get beat in this situation.
Good fastball down around the knees there, taken for a strike.
Your eyes light up from the offensive side playing in a hitter's park like this. Have to get the ball up to do some damage. I'm not mad at that take.
The 3-1. And a good job there to lay off. It's ball four as he becomes their first base runner of the ball game now with two away.
You know, it takes a lot of discipline to watch a pitch like that go by, but on a 3-1 count, he had the luxury of being a little bit more selective up there. Good take, and a walk is the result.
So it's a runner at first with two gone, and that'll bring in a perennial MVP candidate for years to come, Rhys Hoskins. Set and the pitch, and he tries to hold back on the swing, but I think it would have been ruled a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. Harper is off of first with two away.
He's going. He's
Runners
going
off for second. Pitches a cold strike. The throw, and he'll be tagged out at second base, trying to get into scoring position, but instead the inning is over. Another look at the throw down that results in a third out on the bases. An inning in the books, no score on the show. New inning set to get underway. Next, the dangerous power threat, Nolan Gorman.
Gorman.
First delivery to him on the way. And he fouls this one off. This year against right-handed pitching, Gorman carries a batting line a little over the 260 mark. Well, he's got him in the palm of his hand now. 0-2. So far this season, Gorman has a slugging percentage a little over 425, a respectable number. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2.
Man, that's a good take there on that 0-2 fastball just missed. He must have a really good eye at the plate.
he got him.
Man, they've really had his number so far in this series. That's his fifth strikeout in this series alone.
Young.
Paul DeJong digs in next. And his first pitch swinging here as he lines this one into left field for a base hit.
Everyone knows that this guy's numbers are not where he wants them to be so far this year, but you never know about that swing. He looked fluid and confident driving that pitch for a double. We'll see if that gets him going a bit.
So now to the plate, Tyler O'Neill. He'll take a look at a pitch too low. It's ball one. He'll enter play here at 293. 15 long balls and 25 driven in. The 1-0 is looked at for the first strike. No score here as we play inning number two. And he looks at one in there, 1-2.
I got to count 1-2.
And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Hit hard to the right. Foul. One more time. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Waiting on it is Benintendi. And that's the second out of the inning. And no tag at second. He'll head back there with two away now.
Batter, the center fielder, Jackie Bradley Jr.
So a runner in scoring position with two men gone. And in to hit next, it'll be the left-handed batter, Jackie Bradley Jr. Here it comes.
You rarely see a pitcher of this quality throw one right down the middle, and man, as a hitter, probably a good chance you're not going to see that pitch again.
A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. One left for the Cardinals. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Half of the second set to go. Here comes the first baseman, Reese Hoskins. Now here's the pitch. And that's dead center for strike one.
Hey, love the pitcher attacking the zone right here. He knows he's got a patient hitter at the plate. Might as well steal that first strike.
Ball and one strike to the Phillies first baseman. Into the corner and slicing foul. Here's the 1-2 delivery.
That's a ball.
Hit high and deep out there to left center field. And back is Bradley. And that one is gone! Rhys Hoskins with a solo shot. Home run number 9 on the year, and the Phillies grab a 1-0 lead.
Well, if you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in the game.
And the plate now, Reed Scott. Left-handed here as he takes a look at strike one. That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Two balls and two strikes to the Phillies catcher. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full, 3-2.
Well, I'll tell you, if he wants to turn things around, that pitch is one he's going to have to start locating a lot better.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Late on that one as it's foul off to the left side. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. Back up the middle. And that's through for a hit.
I know this guy isn't known for his hitting prowess, but that's a nice job right there. Getting a single on a 3-2 pitch in the middle of the zone. Grab your glove and flash some leather.
And that'll bring up the left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi. Average of just over 300, so clearly he's been a productive player with the bat in his hand so far. Here comes the first pitch. A little tardy there, no balls and a strike.
Hey, if you're able to blow a first pitch fastball by a guy, gotta believe that pitch is coming again right here.
That's taken. Now it's 0-2. Phillies have an early 1-0 lead here in inning number 2. Popped him up. Goldschmidt has room in foul territory. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Batting it, the third baseman, Gene Segura.
Runner at first here with two gone in the inning, and that'll bring in Gene Segura. From the stretch.
Boy, that's out.
The 1-0 is taken, strike one. Runner on first with two away. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Here comes the right fielder. He's got it. A great running play, and that'll retire the side. But the Phillies strike first on this solo home run. We've played two. It's now 1-0 Philadelphia. Back alongside Mark DeRozan, Dan Plesac, Matt Baskirchin here, as it'll be Yadier Molina to lead things off. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. This pitch is popped up.
Hoskins.
And foul ground. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Heading out towards shallow right. Harper has a read on it. And that's the first down of the inning.
That is not the pitcher, number 39, Miles Michael.
So one gone here in the St. Louis third. And into bat next, the pitcher Miles Michaelis. First offering on its way.
Nope, not that.
Swung on and missed. 1-1. Cardinals pitcher up there with a 1-2 count.
Hey, I don't blame him for giving up on that curveball. That was a rainbow coming out of the sky. Stole a strike.
Ball. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2.
You certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Turner's got it. And there's out number two.
The right fielder, number 5.
The next to bat for St. Louis, John Torres. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Here's the first pitch to him.
Shocked he didn't let it fly right there. Usually you're looking for a fastball elevated to get the party started.
Wind up and the 0-1. Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control 0-2.
I know this guy has a lot of weapons on the mound, but what makes him so successful is that he's aggressive in the zone, getting ahead, forcing action.
Wind up and the 0-2 pitch. Breaking ball, and he gets him to chase it in the dirt. Scott gathers, got a throw to first, ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Cardinals. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score.
We're back now as the Phillies prepare for their at-bats here in the third inning. And this lineup has been terrific for this club all year. They come into the game with the fewest strikeouts of any team in the league. And when I caught up with some of the players during batting practice and asked them about that, they all reiterated that they don't want to be an all-or-nothing kind of offensive team. They said it's important to their success that they battle, make pitchers work, and do their best every time up to put the ball in play. Not every team buys into that philosophy, but it definitely seems to work for these guys.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. First pitch coming. Here it is. Grounded back up the middle. That's the first down.
Now batting, the center fielder, Andrew McCutchen.
Here's Andrew McCutchen now. Flied out in his first at bat, so making 0-for-1 so far. And the pitch.
Count 1-0.
Into Molina, now the 1-1. Oh. one out, nobody on. And a wave and a miss on a ball that was way out of the strike zone. There are two away now.
Man, I love watching the pitcher that just rears back and blows smoke by a guy at the letters. That's the ultimate challenge pitching. For me personally, watching hitters swing and miss, man, that's a sight of beauty.
Into the box, Justin Turner. As he'll take a look at a high strike here on the outside corner, it's 0-1. So far, 0-1 with a flyout. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Crowds him a bit with a fastball there, and it's to 1-1. And he lays off upstairs, but it's ruled a strike, and he can't believe it. 1-2. Now here's the pitch. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Phillies down in order. They lead it 1-0. All set for the start of the fourth. Three down to bring in the second baseman, Colton Wong. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Great curveball there. Really fooled him with that one.
I'd like to see this lineup start working the count a little bit more and drive up this pitcher's pitch count.
Now a curveball that he might have flown open a bit. It's 1-1.
That hook stayed up in the zone. You can see he struggled with that curveball early. He's trying to find that release point with his off-speed pitches. Love to see if he can find the feel for that thing moving forward.
Two balls and a strike to the St. Louis leadoff hitter.
We got two balls, one strike.
And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. Easy take there. It's 3-1 now.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
Swing and a ground ball to third. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he'll reach it first.
I know that has to be frustrating from a pitcher's standpoint. But nice execution, nice hustle. Bottom line, nice hustle. Pitcher still one good pitch away from getting done.
You know, D-Lo, one of the things you want to do is make quality pitches as a pitcher. And there's not much you can do right there. You make a pretty good pitch, and the next thing you know, you have a leadoff single on an infield ground ball.
Hey, this is a perfect opportunity for them to get on the board right now. Leadoff man has done his job. Now the middle of the order gets their shot at the plate.
Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there.
Hey, you want to talk about being in the zone. This guy's been raking lately. It all starts with his pitch selection. Two great takes, and he's almost daring the pitcher. Just go ahead and challenge him.
3-0 now.
Wow, this is the kind of count you'd like to get your superstar hitters in, right? 3-0, you can bet he has the green light on this pitch.
From the belt, kicks and deals.
Just the first walk he's given up, along with a couple of hits, so his command has been pretty solid so far.
Now the Cardinals number four hitter, Nolan Gorman, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. First pitch on its way.
Well, they've yet to hang a number on the scoreboard, but it looks like they've got a great opportunity from the breakthrough. Going to be pretty demoralizing if they can't.
4-0 delivery. And 2-0 now as this misses below the knee.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. Down low, and the clock thickens here. 3-0.
Got a good spot to be in right now. Pitch is falling behind in the count with a guy up that hits really well with runners in scoring position.
3-0 pitch.
You maybe get two pitches a game where all the guesswork goes out the window. This is certainly that situation.
And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
Well, it's obvious he wanted absolutely no part of the three or four hole hitters. But he's got to focus here because this guy in the five hole is just as dangerous.
So stepping in, Paul DeYoung, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Here comes the first pitch. Now a check swing, but he holds up in time. Ball one.
When you're hitting in a situation like this, you have to find a way to slow your heart rate down. The pitcher's the one with all the pressure. You're looking to keyhole something middle of the plate and drive some room.
Here it comes, 1-0. Fouled off.
Obviously a huge situation in the game here, but at the plate, he's got to keep it simple. He can't try to do too much just because the bases are juiced. At the very least, just find a way to get that tying run home from third.
Hit back up the middle. And that is through into center field. The base hit. The second will be in time, but the run's going to come in and score.
Oh, man, I don't know how that happened. Looked to be a base hit to the outfield, but then all of a sudden, the throw comes in, and they get the force on the plate. To be honest, that just can't happen.
Settling in now, Tyler O'Neill. He flew out in his last at-bat.
Yeah, give me the same at-bat. As you stride to the plate right here, give me the same execution. Just get something in the air. You got a chance to take the lead right here.
One run, two hits, and no errors so far for the Red Bulls. Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Big pitch coming up right here. He'd love for a ground ball or strikeout.
Quick strikes, and now the 0-2. Struck him out. And now they'll likely need a base hit to get that runner home from third.
Now batter.
The so here now is Jackie Bradley.
Jackie Bradley Jr.
First pitch on its way.
Oh, that's off the plate.
One run, two hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. The fastball that gets the lower part of the zone called for a strike.
Hey, I don't mind that batter taking that strike right there. He's walked a couple people early in this game. Got to find out if he can find the zone. If he wants to walk them all in, we'll take it.
Ready with the 1-1. Can't be held up in time, but that becomes moot as it's a called strike two.
Hey, he's got great feel for that pitch right there. He can throw it anytime he wants for a strike.
Runners at the corners, two men out. Little chopper down the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Here comes the 1-2. 2-2.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
Stung into the gap in right center for what should be extra bases. One run will score easily. Here's the second runner around third.
Safe at the plate.
As they extend the lead a bit, it's now a 3-1 game.
Usually a hitter will shorten the swing with two outs, but not this guy. He puts a big charge into this one and drives in a couple of runs along the way. That can be frustrating as a pitcher when you had a guy on the ropes and you couldn't finish him off, especially when he drives in runs.
Yadi Molina digging in now as the first pitch to him was taken low and away for ball one. Runner in scoring position with two gone. Again, 2-0.
He certainly has an open base down there, but you don't want your defender standing flat-footed for much longer.
Two-0 count. The pitch. Fastball looked at to a strike. Three runs already home here. Two and two to the Cardinals catcher. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. He struck him out. Seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. So they pick up three runs on only two hits in the inning. No errors and a runner left. To the bottom of inning number four we go. Cards lead it 3-1. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And next it'll be the outfielder, Bryce Harper.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs. But it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
Popped up. Goldschmidt is there to put this one away, and perhaps an over-anxious Harper is set down on the first pitch he sees.
Every pitcher loves to get quick outs, right? How about that? One pitch, one out, a pop-up to start the inning.
So one away here with the bases empty, and that'll bring up Rhys Hoskins. Here's the first pitch to him. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball.
Man, this guy's been incredibly efficient so far in this one, mostly because he's getting ahead. 70% of the batters he's faced, he's thrown the first pitch strike to.
1-1. And it's fouled away. The 1-2. Now a swing, and he gets him to pop it up, but this will land untouched. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time. 3-1 is our score here in inning number four. 3-2 now. Oh, a big rip at the curveball, but he didn't get it, and he becomes the second casualty of the inning. So next to the plate for Phils, Scott. He reached on a single in his first try. Here it comes. Skied in the air to straightaway left. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. Score holds, it's 3-1. So here now is the pitcher, Miles Michaelis. And I'm sure the starter on the mound would like to hit the rewind button on that last inning.
Oh, no doubt about that. That was a really rocky frame, but clearly not enough to chase him from this game. We'll see if he's still shaking a bit or if he's able to put this behind him.
Now here's the pitch. And he throws the fastball by him here. 0-1. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. Two balls and a strike to the St. Louis leadoff hitter. Not cheated on that one. It's 2-2. Now the pitch.
I got 3-2.
John Torres will be next. On its way is pitch number 75. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Giving chase is Benintendi. He's there and records the first down.
Up next to the Cardinals, the right fielder. Go red.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go John Torres. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Gotta find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
Sent on the ground out to second. Kingery's there. Throw in time at first for out number two.
Now back. Second baseman. Colquhoun. One.
Bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up Colton Wong. First pitch on its way.
Ball, that's in.
Pulled toward right center field. On the move is Harper. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Down in order go the Cardinals, but they hang on to a 3-1 lead. And we're back from Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. Let's check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, I talked with Philadelphia's manager during the break about the Phillies' offensive production to this point, and he told me the quality of their swings needs to improve as the game moves forward. They're struggling to drive the baseball into the gaps right now, as only one of their hits has been for extra bases. That makes it pretty tough to generate runs, but he said it's up to everyone in the lineup to make the necessary adjustments. It hasn't gone their way to this point, but that shouldn't mean they can't put together some great swings the rest of the way.
Way to go.
Thank you, Heidi.
No one here. Andrew.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Andrew Benintendi is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. 0-1. Here's the pitch. High in the air, carrying well out to deep center. And back is Bradley. On the track. On the warning track, he makes the catch.
The batter, number four, second baseman, Scott Kingery.
And in steps Scott Kingery. First offering on its way. Fastball on the inner third, taken for a strike. Tried to pull that one back, but he couldn't do it, and it's 0-2 now. And Strike three called on the outside corner. He's earned the right to live out there with the fastballs as that's out number two.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. Now a swing and a hard-hit grounder. This will get foul for strike two. 3-1 our score as we play inning number five. This is flared out towards second, and this will be put away easily for the out. Phillies down in order, and it remains a 3-1 ball game. Here's Paul Goldschmidt now. He'll begin things here against Aaron Nola.
Paul Goldschmidt.
First pitch coming. Here it is.
1-0.
Now some movement out in the Phillies bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen. High fly ball out to straightaway center. McCutcheon is under it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Now batting, the third baseman, Nola Gourmet.
Stepping up now, Nolan Gorman. Ready with the first pitch, here it comes. Curveball, and this is in the dirt for ball one. High and deep to right. Back goes Harper. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Eighth home run on the season for him. And the Cardinals open it up now. It's 4-1.
I know hindsight's 20-20, but you can't throw that pitch to that guy. Don't forget, he homered yesterday, so you know he's locked in and ready to roll up there. We'll see if he learns from that mistake.
Here comes the Philly skipper on his way out toward the mound, and a change is in the offing, as that'll be all for his starter this afternoon. Gone after 5 1/3 here, as he never really found his groove in this one.
Ladies,
Zach Eflin, right-hander standing 6'6", now will take over pitching duties here.
Number 56.
So that brings in the power-hitting middle infielder, Paul DeJong. As he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. 1-for-2 in the ballgame thus far. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. Got him to swing at a pitch below the knees, 1-1. Eflin is a reliever known for forcing contact. Not a huge strikeout guy most of the time, but he also doesn't issue a lot of free passes either.
There's a couple of keys to being a good reliever. One, if you have great stuff and you strike everybody out, or like this guy, not afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. He has good stuff, not great stuff. He's not afraid to let his defense help him out and make some plays.
Boom, that liner caught him. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. And now they'll hustle out there and attend to their pitcher. And that was quite a shot he took, as you see him down on a knee. But if there's one thing I know about this guy, he will not want to come out of this game. And from all indications, it looks like he's going to try to continue. To the plate now, Tyler O'Neill. A ball and no strikes. No hits to this point.
Ball one, no strike.
Changeup stays outside and he's behind 2-0.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
Side 3-0 now. Jackie Bradley Jr. waits on deck. Three and one to the Cardinals left fielder.
Now that's a really curious pitch selection. 3-0 and turned at the slider. You have to wonder if maybe he's lost the feel for his fastball.
Guide into straightaway right. Harper has a read on it. Two down.
Now batter, the center fielder, Jackie Bradley Jr.
Stepping in for the Cardinals, Jackie Bradley Jr. One for two with a double on the ledger so far. From the stretch. Fouled away. Two out with the man at first. There's one that misses high. It's 1-1. In the dirt here. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. From the stretch. And he goes down and gets this fastball and takes it high in the air to deep straightaway center. And off the batter's eye for a home run. An impressive shot to dead center field. Two-run shot to straightaway center. Third home run for him on the year. And it's now a 6-1 ball game.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
Here's the catcher, Yadier Molina.
Yadier.
High in the air out to center field. McCutchen is in his tracks now as he tucks this one away to retire the side. So two home runs in the inning lead to three runs on the scoreboard. 9-1-2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. The Cardinals are out in front 6-1. Omar Narvaez is going to come off the bench as he'll be asked to lead off the bottom of inning number six.
Omar Narvaez.
And that misses ball one. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. The 1-0. Swung on and missed, strike one.
Yeah, flip a coin right here. I don't know what you sit on. Fastball in, then a breaking ball down and away. Pick your spot and go with it.
The 1-1 home. On the ground to the right side. Wong is there. And that's out number one.
Good range shot off into the hole right there. That's not an easy play, but these guys make it look that way sometimes.
One out for the Phillies in their half of the sixth, and that'll bring up the former National League MVP, Andrew McCutchen. Here comes the first pitch.
Ball, that's out.
Man, this guy has retired a whole slew right now. I think what he needs to do is just stay focused and keep attacking the game plan like he has up to this point, because everything he's done has worked.
Now the 1-0.
You could bet he wants that one back at the plate right now. That's a pitch you normally see a guy drive if he has the right approach going.
The 1-1 home. Waves and misses for strike number two.
Yeah, Matty, he's had these guys on a proverbial rocking horse all night. Changing speeds, hitting every quadrant. He's tough to hit.
Now a swing, and he gets him to pop it up. No problem over there for Goldschmidt, and there are two gone now.
Now batter, the shortstop, Justin
Turner. Into the box, Justin Turner. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. First delivery to him on the way.
Hey! Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never easy to pitch on the road, but to have this kind of outing in a ballpark that is notoriously known as being hitter-friendly, it's been a treat to watch.
And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And Goldschmidt will make the catch, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. They trail 6-1. Welcome back. Here's Heidi Watney with the report as we get set for the top of the seventh. Heidi?
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Cardinals to discuss his thoughts on his lineup so far. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
He said they've done a nice job of keeping their swings inside the strike zone and not chasing after pitches they can't do much with. The numbers say their chase rate in this game is under 25%. And with a bunch of runs on the board right now, could be a big reason
now
why.
Now pitching for the Phillies.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Francisco Liriano is on the pitch from the bullpen now, starting in number seven. Seventh inning ready to roll. And into bat next, the pitcher, Miles Michaelis.
The pitcher, number 39, Miles Michaelis.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Ball two.
And that's too high. Ball two.
In this situation right here, I'm protecting my pitcher from himself. I know he wants to swing the bat and let the boys know in the clubhouse that he can do his job, but I'm probably putting a take sign on right here.
Now the pitch.
Ball, that's inside.
It's amazing how guys can lose focus sometimes when the weaker hitters come up, especially the pitchers. You got to stay on the attack and minimize pitches and get these guys out in a hurry.
The 3-0. Hey. And that's in there on the hands, 3-2 now. And the payoff pitch. Full count still. Takes this the other way to right. And the pitcher's got himself a base hit.
He came to play today. not just only on the ball right there. He's thrown the ball well, but on the offensive side of the ball, he's able to contribute and help this offense put itself in position to score some more runs.
Standing in now, John Torres. He gets it hard on the ground to the left. To second for one, on to first, and they get the double play.
Now that second baseman, Colton Wong.
Stepping into the box, Colton Wong has got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Pitch coming. Here it is. Bases are empty here with two men out. Line toward the alley in left center. And a knock for him this time. He's two for four for the game.
You'd think they'd stop pitching to this guy by now. He's been torching them all weekend, and he stays hot here with another extra base hit. They'll be happy when this series is over, so they don't have to deal with this dude anymore.
Stepping in now, Paul Goldschmidt. As he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. One pitch.
Ball one.
Popped him up. And Hoskins is there to make the catch. The inning is over. Cards lead one. They hold on to their 6-1 lead.
Very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike.
I really like how he's been attacking hitters early in these ABs. He's thrown strikes on the first pitch to over 70% of the guys he's faced so far.
Swings and hits it very well to right. Right fielder looking up. Track the wall. Goodbye, home run. Solo home run off the bat of Bryce Harper. Home run number 16 for him on the year. As the lead is cut to four, it's 6-2 now. For him so far. Hoskins behind the count 0-2.
That's a tough curveball right there to stay into as a lefty hitter. That ball looks like it's almost going to hit you, and it breaks over the inside half of the plate.
Might have been looking to find that outside corner, but he couldn't quite get it there. It's 1-2.
Hey, the fish ain't biting there on that 0-2 breaking ball, but you got to be careful because this pitcher might throw him another one.
And a swing and a miss there on a late breaking slider as he set down on strikes for the second time this afternoon.
Classic slider down and away from the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand. So they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
And now Reed Scott as he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. A 1-0 home. It's laid off for ball two. Too tight with that one. 3-0.
3-0.
Andrew Benintendi is on deck. And this misses here for ball four. Just the second walk he's issued here into his seventh inning of work.
Now batting left fielder, Andrew.
Left-handed hitting Andrew Benintendi stands in. First offering on its way. Into center field, line drive, base hit. Long throw to third. And safe.
That had to be in the scouting report right there. You don't see too many OO breaking ball ambushes in the game. He had to know that pitch was coming.
So now to the plate, Scott Kingery. He'll take a look at a curveball that drops in there on the outer half. It's strike one. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball.
This guy uses that two-seamer to set up his other pitches. Two-seamer in, breaking ball away.
The 1-1 pitch on a line to shortstop.
Third baseman number two, Gee.
Striding into the box, Gene Segura. Two outs and two runners aboard here in the seventh inning. First, and he'll be back in standing up. From the stretch. Looked like he tried to pull it there, but he swings right through the fastball. Runners on first and third, two away. Good hard slider there, but it runs away. It's a ball and a strike.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
The 2-1 home is swung on and missed, and that's strike two. Runners at the corners, two men out. Just hung in there on that one. The 2-2 one more time. Laid off and the count runs full.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Now the payoff pitch home. Hit hard to third. He's got it. On to first, and that'll do it as they manage to not let this inning get out of hand. Bills draw bit closer thanks to this solo home run. We'll march on to the eighth. It's the Cardinals 6 and the Phillies 2. Digging in, Nolan Gorman.
We didn't go last at that, Eddie D. We heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
First offering on its way. I'm putting lay off the pitch inside. It's 0-1. And it's quickly 0-2. Nothing in two count and the pitch.
I got to count 1-2.
Lifted down the line and left. And no one will track it down.
Hey, that fastball caught too much of the plate on an 0-2 count.
The 1-2. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Now batting. Shortstop.
Digging in. Paul DeJong. Two for three with a double on his line so far. Here comes the first pitch. Boy, and good pop to the fastball there from Liriano. Strike one. Now the pitch. Slow grounder to first. Hoskins gathers it in. And he'll step on first for the out. Three unassisted.
Good pitch right there to run the two-seamer in on his hands and bunch him up. And an easy ground ball is the result.
So coming to the plate, Tyler O'Neill. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Jumpy there as he swings through the fastball.
The problem for the batter now is he's gotten so inside conscious after those first two pitches, anything on the outer half of the plate's going to look a foot outside.
Throw in time and the side is retired. So they go quietly here in this half inning. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. St. Louis is out in front, 6-2. Howie Kendrick. Come on now as a pinch hitter, so that'll spell the end for Francisco Liriano.
Number 47, Howie.
And he takes ball one. Still struggling at the plate with an average well under 200. No home runs as of yet and four RBIs. The 1-0 home. It's a fastball that misses. Swinging a ball line down in the left field corner. But this will be foul. High and deep to right center. Chasing after it is Bradley. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
The center fielder, Andrew Hopkins.
Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Andrew McCutchen. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. First pitch on its way.
Hey!
Bases are empty, one man out. Barely able to make contact, down 0-2 now. Down the third baseline. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first.
Hey, that's great hustle right there out of the box. Not everybody's getting it right out of the chute from step one, but I have to ask you, Dan, how frustrating executing a pitch in this infield.
It is, D-Roy. You can read that right off the bat as a pitcher. You can read the angle. You know that that ball is going to be hit on the ground, and you're thinking deep down inside, okay, there's a quick out, and it just wasn't meant to be.
Into the box, Justin Turner. And he'll take a look at ball one. Next pitch here will be number 100 through 7 1/3.
Man, I'd love to see a complete game. He's certainly on his way. If he can keep the number down, the pitch count down, he's got a shot at this.
Yeah, D-Ro, this is every manager's dream spot right now. You're one out into the eighth inning. Your starter's giving you some good baseball. And you could go to your better relievers now towards the end of the ballgame. This is set up perfectly right now.
Throw won't get him.
Boy, this is just a case of another really good hitter finding a way, even though that was a soft flyer, finding a way to get hits.
Yeah, he usually hits rockets and catches the barrel, but even his soft liners fall. Dan, he has a knack for keeping his bat in his zone and giving himself a chance much longer than the average ball player.
Here comes the Cardinal manager up out of the dugout, out to the mound. And he's going to motion for the bullpen, as that'll be all for his starter this afternoon. So he was able to only get that first out in the eighth, but nonetheless, he'll depart with the lead. Jordan Hicks takes the mound to try to get out of this mess. There are two on with only one away. Here's Bryce Harper now. He'll take a look at a strike right down the middle. It's 0-1. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Left side, but well fouled.
Boy, the Phillies have been looking for some offense all game long. They've yet to find it. Let's hope they can find it pretty soon.
A little chopper up the middle. DeYoung's got it. Wrong for one.
Thank you, Jeff.
One's all they were ever going to get, and the inning will continue.
They couldn't turn the inning-ending double play. They just get the force out at second, and the runner scores from third.
So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that'll bring in a perennial MVP candidate for years to come, Reese Hoskins. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Oh, that one got the pitcher. No chance to make the play. Let's just hope he's okay on the mound. And time now to see quite where that got him. And it appears from here at least, and his actions on the field confirm it, it looked like it got him on its drive leg, which could be problematic, of course, for him. But from the way he's trying to walk it off, I think he's going to try to continue. Standing in, Reed Scott. And Ben, what's the plan of attack here for the guy on the mound?
Well, I think they have to go right after him. He's pretty unlikely to take you deep, but if you allow him to get on base, the chances of him scoring and tying this game become a lot greater.
Here comes the first pitch. Starts him out with a slider for a strike. Way the 0-1 pitch. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Boy, this is one of those ABs you like to hit the rewind button on. Put himself in a tough spot now, hitting with two strikes.
Here comes the nothing and two pitch.
Nope, at the ball.
These are the situations right here that make me miss wearing the uniform. The big spot, the cat and mouse of what's he going to throw. I'm down 1-2. Can I battle back? The pitcher's trying to put me away. This is what the game's all about.
Two men are on with two men out. A swing, and this one is blasted to right field. Nothing's going to stop it. That one is out of here. This game is tied. So it's a three-run shot to straightaway right field as they pull even. It's 6-6 now. A ball and a strike. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up.
Ball two.
Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. From the windup, the 2-1 pitch. This is hit the other way out toward left field. O'Neill waits on it, and the inning is over. But four runs score in the inning, three coming right here on the three-run home run. Ninth inning straight ahead. And we're all even now at 6-6. Mike Morin will be on the mound to start the ninth inning, and his job will be keeping the ball game tied until the bottom half. All set to start the ninth in this one, and in to hit next, it'll be the left-handed batter, Jackie Bradley Jr.
Yeah, that last at-bat, Danny, he turned that fastball on. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile, but... Listen, home run, home run.
Ninth inning begins as the first pitch is taken for ball one. Morin was known as a short relief specialist, the guy who came in, got one or two big outs, but with the new pace of play rules, they're forcing a change for this right-hander.
Well, that's a nasty breaking ball right there. Backdoor slider, just missed the corner. As they say, that's a Hall of Fame pitch.
Now the 2-0.
Ball, back down.
Morin. Minnesota-born ball player. He was a 13th round pick during the first year player draft of 2012.
I know this guy wouldn't go into the category of superstar, but to grind out the career he has being drafted where he was, my hat's off.
Lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Well, that is definitely not the way to start an inning. One thing to give up a walk, but to do it on four pitches is pretty alarming. He looks a little thrown off right now.
Now time is called, and we'll have a pinch runner at first, and that'll be a wise decision as he's the potential go-ahead run. Ready for another chance? Yadier Molina, go-ahead run at first, nobody out.
I mean, Yadi, when he first broke on the scene, was a defender first and foremost. You can't say that anymore. I mean, he's evolved into a really, really nice offensive player.
Here's the first pitch. Slider bounces, and that gets away. And a very big mistake, as that'll move the possible go-ahead run into scoring position.
Well, now might be a good time to make a visit to the mound. Your pitcher walks the first batter and allows him to get into scoring position with the wild pitch. Got to settle him down and make sure everything's all right physically.
can't sit back long enough, and the count evens up at 1-1. This is on the ground over the first. Oh, look at the sliding stuff.
You got it. Wow.
Well, good fundamental baseball might just win him this ballgame. They had the go-ahead run at second base, so this guy knows exactly what he has to do. Just a simple ground ball to the right side gets that guy to third, and now all sorts of ways to take the lead.
Jairo Munoz
will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Jairo Munoz.
This is a strikeout situation, but it's also a ground ball situation. I expect we'll see a lot of pitches down in the zone trying to prevent the hitter from getting the ball up in the air.
The 1-0. Count now a ball and a strike. The 1-1 pitch. This is chopped down the third baseline. Now the 1-2 pitch. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with one away. And that's a good eye as he works the count back four.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Swing and a miss. He struck him out. And a big out there. The go-ahead run stays at third with two gone now. And now back to the leadoff spot in the St. Louis lineup. Stepping in, number five. His day at the plate hasn't amounted to much. 0-4, but this is a great opportunity to make amends.
Well, if your team really needs you, like they need it right here, you have to be able to put your personal struggles out of your mind. Right now is all that matters.
Here's the first pitch. No balls and one strike. That's in there. And he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. The 0-2.
One ball.
Hey, that 0-2 fastball wasn't even close, but on hit right now. I'm still sitting on that heater.
Ready with the 1-2. And two strikes now. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with two down. High in the air out to center field. McCutcheon is under it. And that ends the inning. One left for the Cardinals. Score remains tied 6-6. Harrison Bader will stay in the ballgame as he takes over in center.
Now playing center field, number 48.
John Brebbia comes on to work on the mound, hoping to send this one into extra innings.
Number 50, John Brebbia.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And set to go is the second baseman, Scott Kingery.
Kingery.
to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Foul tip into the catcher's glove at strike one. Strike two as the fastball is let go. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. The 0-2 home.
Well, he tried to throw a high fastball right by him there. Didn't work, but now we'll see if that sets up some different options. Wouldn't be surprised to see a good slider down and away right here.
The 1-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Foul tip is held onto by Molina. A fine play there by the veteran backstop to help record the punch out.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with a strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
And that'll bring up Gene Segura. As the first pitch here is a bit high, it's ball one. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. Now the 1-0.
Hey, looks like this guy's going to work in the upper part of the strike zone. It'll be interesting to see if this lineup can adjust to the way he pitches.
Ball behind now to 1-2. Pitch on the way. This is in the air out to straightaway center. Bader is there now, and he has it. Two gone.
Now batter, the pitcher, Mike Moran.
Jake Bruce, grab a bat to pinch hit here, and you wonder if he'll be swinging for the downs, trying to walk off with a victory. Good take there to lay off the high fastball. Still plenty to be desired in terms of batting average, down in the 180s entering play. Five homers and a dozen RBIs. One and oh, here it is. Hit sharply toward the right side. And that is in there for a two-out base knock.
Hey, that's a nice piece of hitting right there. Two-out base knock to put the winner on the right base. Let's see if someone can catch a gap in that match.
Now time is called, and a very wise decision here with the potential winning run at first. They'll opt to put a little extra speed on the base path. So the next hitter to dig in will be Andrew McCutchen. See the look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He's got a chance to end this one and send these fans home happy if he can get a ball deep enough into the gap. 2-0 to the Philly center fielder.
Two balls, no strike.
Possibly winning run stands at first with two out here. And he just misses inside with the fastball there.
Yeah, it looked like he was going to cruise through this inning, but now a hit. If Rio count had changed that, got to get back in the strike zone right here.
Three balls, no strikes.
Nope,
and that misses ball four. So now the potential winning run moves into scoring position where a single could earn this.
call, man. I think this walk is going to grind at him for a bit. He just missed, and now the inning continues with a man in scoring position.
So digging in with a chance to win it here, Justin Turner. As he'll look to get the ball into the outfield and bring home what would be the winning run from second base. First pitch is a slider, called for a strike. Possible winning runs at second with two down, however. Got him to go after that one. He's in a quick hole, 0-2.
As a hitter, you see a pitcher working east-west. This is where you got to tell yourself to stay tall. You can't cover both sides of the plate. You got to pick one and trust it.
Now the 0-2 pitch. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
You know he's probably cheating on that inside pitch after he got jammed earlier. If you're on the mound right now, you're going to try to hit that outside corner, and there's a pretty good chance you'll get him to roll over something.
Now the 1-2 pitch.
Too much bite on the breaking ball that time as it's well off the outside. This is a huge pitch right here. I don't think he wants to go 3-2 and have those runners be in motion. Look for him to be aggressive with what he thinks is his best pitch.
Here's the 2-2 pitch.
For the guy in the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Possible winning runs at second with two down, however. We got him, and the go-ahead run will be left stranded at second base. So they can't get that winning run home, and that means free baseball here this afternoon. 10th inning coming up, and we are all even at 6 apiece. David Robertson takes the mound as he'll be the first man to pitch here in extra innings.
David Robertson.
We are into extra innings, and that'll bring up Colton Wong.
The second baseman, Colton Wong.
First pitch coming, here it is. Knuckle third down below the knees, 1-0. Now the pitch. Cut fastball, and it's 5-1. And the pitch.
Oh, that's off the plate.
Misses inside, and the count's run full now, 3-2. On deck, the powerful right-handed bat of Paul Goldschmidt. On the ground to third, there's Segura. Throw to first, gets him, one out here to lead off the 10th.
Now batter, the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Stepping up to the plate, Paul Goldschmidt. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Chopped to third. Reined in. And that's the second out.
Now batting. First baseman. Nolan Gorman.
At the plate, Nolan Gorman. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. First pitch is a fastball inside, 1-0. Now some back action in the Phillies bullpen as a right-hander begins to crank it up out there. And he goes down and gets this fastball and takes it high in the air to deep straightaway center. And he's going to make the catch. And he paid a big price for it, too, as he crashes headlong into the wall. One more look at the final out. A teeth rattler if ever there was one. A chance to win it now as we head to the bottom of the 10th, still tied. Alex Reyes comes on to start the home 10th, and he's just hoping to get this one into the 11th inning.
Number 29, Alex Reyes.
Ready for the bottom of the 10th here. And coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Bryce Harper. Field in the overshift here. Now the pitch.
1-0. Hey. 1-1.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner. Oh, and that nearly sent us home and sent this crowd into hysterics, but it wind up a foul ball. The 1-2. Misses ball two.
He got ahead with two good fastballs and then tried to drop the changeup to see if he'd be out in front. Did a great job of laying off that pitch right there. Interested to see where he goes now.
Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now. If I'm on the mound, I want this guy up right now. He's the guy that's going to beat me.
And he struck him out.
Big curveball for the strikeout there, and that came after an absolute missile of a fastball. Even if you recognize the breaking ball out of the pitcher's hand, it's so hard for hitters to sit back long enough after they've seen a really good fastball. Only the best can keep their hands back on those.
And that will bring up the Sacramento product, Reese Hoskins, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls in the strike. Two hits in four attempts to this point. One on its way.
Ball, that's out.
Cardinals get the bullpen started here as a right-hander's up and warming. Looking to Molina, now the 1-1.
Hey.
Big breaking ball, and a beauty that time, 1-2.
Hey, I don't mind that tape right there. That was a nasty breaking ball. Started outside the zone, popped back inside the zone. Good spin rate on it. Move on to the next pitch.
That's in. Ball two.
Two balls and two strikes now. One out, nobody on. Still 2-2. Chopper left side of the infield. In time to first, and there are two away.
Now batting, Tucker Reed. Cut.
Now in the box, Reed Scott, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
One of the things this guy would like to do from the left side is swing it a little bit better against right-handed pitching. This guy has decent numbers, but not great numbers against right-handed pitchers.
In there, and he's ahead 0-2 now.
You know, it's great to be patient, make a pitcher work and all that stuff to try to get walks, but you have to be ready to hit. And that was a really hittable pitch, and now you've got to deal with an 0-2 count.
A ball and two strikes now.
Hey, textbook waste pitch right there. Does he go elevated fastball again or something slow below the zone?
Pops this one up. Gorman in foul ground. And this will land foul.
A ball and two strikes.
And he fouls this one off. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. And he chased it in the dirt. Throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Nothing doing here this half, and we'll have to cancel those dinner reservations, partner. 11th inning coming up, and we are all even at 6 apiece. 11th inning set to get underway, and that'll bring forth the slugging shortstop, Paul DeYoung. He's set, and the pitch. And a high strike to begin the at bat. It's 0-1.
At the
1-1.
1-1.
Two balls and a strike to the St. Louis leadoff hitter. Just behind the fastball there. Two strikes now. Outside and a full count, 3-2.
Talk about a waste pitch on 2-2. That one wasn't even close. I don't know anyone that would have swung at that pitch.
And possibly an interesting development here. It's a leadoff walk to begin the frame in extra innings.
Man, when the game is tied, the last thing you can afford to do is walk the leadoff hitter. Got to focus on getting that ground ball now.
So a runner at first now with nobody out. And into bat next will be Tyler O'Neill. Here's the first pitch. Trying to get that go-ahead run to scoring position now as he puts this one down. Turner for one. And the relay won't nearly be in time as he's there easily.
It's really tough to double up a guy with the speed that he has. And he was hustling all the way on this ground ball. So they should be happy they at least got the guy out at second. It'll be interesting now to see if he tries to use that speed again and swipe a bag and get into scoring position.
Here's the first pitch.
Strike one to start the at-bat.
This is a tough guy to turn two on. It's got to be hit hard, and if you're an infielder, you've got to catch it and get rid of it quickly.
Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Takes a pitch high and away for ball one. Swing and miss, and it's all the two strikes here. Now the 1-2 pitch. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And that'll get by into center field for a base hit. Throw into third. And he is in there at third with the possible go-ahead score. And he needed extra innings to get it, but there's his first hit of the game, and that'll keep the hit streak alive and kicking.
Tito, that's one of the beautiful things about the game of baseball, right? You go extra innings, that lineup turns over, and was able to get him one extra AB.
Yeah, and he'd be lying right now if he
said he wasn't thinking about it. The boys hooked him up right there. Pitching staff extended the game a little bit. One more plate appearance, and he extends the hit.
Laid off, but a called strike as that caught the outside. Looking at his lifetime numbers, Molina has a .280 batting average. The 0-1. In the dirt and blocked behind the plate. Runners will stay put. However, the count evens at one. Runners are at the corners with one man out. And this pitch misses for a ball. 2-1 now to Molina.
Hey, lots of guys get too aggressive in a spot like this, but he's done a nice job of gaining some top leverage. Look for him to put the ball in play hard.
Hit on the ground to third. Segura has it. Second for one. Relayed at first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. Another chance to win it here to the bottom of the 11th. All time. Stepping into the box, Andrew Benintendi comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Hey, I'm surprised he went to that spot in the zone. This guy's known for being a down and in hitter. Don't expect too many pitches going in that spot.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Swing and a miss, and he's in trouble now, 0-2. Well, I think his eyes lit up when he saw that pitch coming up at his eye level.
Oh, you think? If you've got a good fastball like he does, that location can be really effective. It looks so tempting to the hitter, but making contact on that pitch could be very tough.
And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
If you've got a good fastball going and they're not handling, keep throwing it. Right there, three fastballs in a row. He gone.
At the plate now, Scott Kingery. She'll lay off a curveball up in the zone for a ball, 1-0. Struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. Left it up in the zone, but it's a strike, 1-1. The fastball by him here. 1-2 now. I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball. Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose. Got him. And he goes down on strikes for the third time.
Two down on two. Strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Gene Segura standing in. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. The windup and the 1-0. 2-0.
He may be down 2-0 after those first two pitches in this AB, but those are pitches he can feel pretty good about. They did miss by a whole lot, so it's not like he's all over the place.
Hitters count the pitch. And a good comeback fastball there. It's two balls and a strike.
Well, he was definitely trying to end it with one swing at a bat right there, leaving nothing to the imagination. That's the problem sometimes. Everyone wants to be a hero in extra innings instead of just getting on base and playing it like another inning.
Even count, two balls and two strikes. Full count now, 3-2.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
Pounded softly down the line toward first. On the first.
first, and that'll mean a 12th inning is in order as this inning is over. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. 11 innings in the books now, and we are all even at 6 apiece. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Pete Pitorano gets the ball as he'll take over to start this 12th inning.
Now pitcher and batting in the 7th. Number 64, Victor Arano. Now playing
Tucker. We'll grab a bat and hit for the
number
pitcher.
Three, Cole Tucker.
Line drive to left. Gets down and got himself a base hit. So the inning's underway with the Cardinals getting their leadoff hitter on base.
Up next to the Cardinals, the right fielder, Yon Torres.
Standing in now, John Torres. Go-ahead runs the board here at first with nobody out. For the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. The 0-1. Showing bunt, but he winds up taking ball one. Sacrifice attempt as he gets it down. Turner for one. Relay throw, but it'll be too late as he's well safe for
second base. Taking one.
Here's the second baseman, Colton Wong. It's one away. The runner at first represents the potential go-ahead score. Double play is in order, however. Here's the first pitch.
Oh.
Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Really pulled that one across as the slider misses well inside. Strike called. Now the throw down. And it's far too late as he steals second with ease.
Hey, it's almost impossible to throw a base runner out that gets a lead that big. And plus, this catcher's not known for having a cannon of an arm.
Now the 2-1. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Waiting on it is Benintendi. And he makes the catch for the second out.
Now batting, the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Into the box now, Paul Goldschmidt. It's his job to get something into the outfield and give that go-ahead run a chance to score from second. Here's the first pitch. Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with two down. Wing, miss one and one.
Got to sit middle when a guy's trying to pitch around you. If he's going to give you first base, take it.
Ground ball, right side. Hoskins has it. Oh, on the first, gets it, and the side is behind. Cards lead one. This game remains tied at 6. Martinez, he's summoned here to start the home 12th, and the best case scenario for him is to take us to the 13th.
Martinez.
set to get his day started. Logan Forsythe.
Way to go.
It's been a real struggle for him with the bat so far this year. But he'll get things turned around in a hurry. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And he runs it in on him and gets him to swing through it for strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Lifted down the line and left. Left fielder giving chase. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning.
Now batting, the center fielder, Andrew McCutchen.
So the Phillies batting order turns over and set to go. Andrew McCutchen. It was a walk in his last trip. First pitch coming. Here it is.
Ball.
Bases are empty. One man. That evens it up. 1-1. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1. Now here's the pitch. And a 2-1 slider is looked at for a called strike two.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
2-2. Hit the other way out toward right field. Torres back in plenty of time to put this away, however, and there are two gone.
Now batting, shortstop, Justin Turner.
Digging in once again, Justin Turner, and looking to improve on a 1-for-5 effort so far. First pitch of the at-bat. Bounce towards the second baseman. On to first, and we're headed to 13 as that ends the inning. Phillies down in order. Weird, still tied 6-6. So here's the cleanup hit. Nolan McCormick is 1-for-4 for the game. First pitch on its way.
Gorman.
All one, no play.
The
1-0.
Two tough sliders right there, but he was able to lay off him. Might have bought himself a fastball in this situation.
2-0 home. Was offered at and missed for the first strike.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Hit softly down the line at first, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Here it comes. Ball three. 3-2 now. Paul DeJong will be next. Down the first baseline. This will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Full count pitch home. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this game. Now with the play, Paul DeJong. Double and single in four at-bats in this contest.
DeJong.
First offering on its way.
Hey!
Plain to see right there that the manager's sticking up for his hitter, making sure that that strike zone gets a little bit tighter. It's tough to cover both sides of the plate, and they both want that strike zone to be shrinked up a little bit.
Fouled off. One out, nobody on. Weak grounder down the line at third. throw just does beat him to the bag, as that was pretty close.
Now back, left fielder, Tyler.
Riding in, Tyler O'Neill attempting to, as they say, get off the schneid here. 0 for 5 so far. He's set, here it comes. Two out, nobody on. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2. And he strikes it out here for round number 3, so after a scoreless count. Yet another shot to end it right here as we move on to the home half of the inning. Last half of the 13th inning set to go. Standing in is the veteran outfielder, Bryce Harper. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. And having played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. And a good throw gets him one gun.
Well executed two-seamer on the outside corner that time. And that's what you'll get a lot of with that pitch. He rolled right over.
Grounder down the line at third. And that's a fair ball as this one gets by him at third.
A nice piece of hitting right there to put the winning run on base. I know there's one out in the inning. But there's one more to play that they could potentially be productive with. But this guy's looking at endless right now. Put something up there.
Into the box now, Reed Scott. As he connects on the first pitch with a fly ball to center. Bader comes on now and makes the catch in shallow center for round number 2.
Now batter.
Ready once again, Andrew Benintendi has struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he...
down on just 4 pitches. All set to begin the 14th inning. And next to bat will be the outfielder, Harrison Bader. Here's the first pitch to him. Comes the 0-1. Swinging strike, and now it's 0-2. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
It's so hard to hit when you're behind the count 0-2, right? You have to protect the fastball. You have to look for the soft stuff down and away. You're really at a disadvantage when you fall behind 0-2.
At the plate, Yadier Molina. And it's fouled away. He was a double play victim last time around. The count from Molina. Oh, and ouch, that one drilled him. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. And now they'll hustle now out there and attend to their pitcher. And that was quite a shot he took, as you see him down on a knee. But if there's one thing I know about this guy, he will not want to come out of this game. And from all indications, it looks like he's going to try to continue. Andrew Kisner will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Andrew Kisner.
Just able to get a piece of that for strike one. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Now the 0-2 pitch. In the dirt, and now let's see. In time, as he just gets the tag down. Strikes him out here for round number three, so after a scoreless top half, they'll have a chance to win it here in the bottom half. Redbirds down quietly. This game remains tied at six. Giovanni Gallegos is going to finally make an appearance in this one as he'll take over in the 14th inning.
Giovanni Gallegos.
Corey Dickerson will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. Slider laid off for the ball. According to the career numbers on the back of his baseball card, Dickerson has a .280 batting average. Ready with the 1-0 pitch. Ball and two strikes now. Dickerson, a 6'1" left-handed hitter, but throws right-handed. This is the final year of his current deal, so he'll be a free agent at season's end.
You know, Matty, I know he's in the final year of his contract, but he's playing to expectations, to be honest with you. I know he wants to turn it up a little bit, though, as he approaches the end of the season and make that salary push as he heads towards free agency again.
Stepping in now, Gene Segura, as he'll take a look at a strike on the outside corner. It's 0-1. Bases are empty, one man. Lifted down the line and left. And this will not be caught. It's a foul ball. Way the 0-2 pitch. Popped him up. Molina over to his left. Two gone.
Up next to Philadelphia.
Digging in for his second at bat. Logan Forsythe. So far, 0-1 with a flyout. From the stretch. Down the left field line and deep. And this will wind up a foul ball. Comes set, the 0-1. Rounded down the third baseline. But that'll get fouled. It's 0-2 now. Nothing in two, the pitch. Couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2. And he strikes him out to retire the side. So we'll for Philadelphia. Weird, still tied 6-6. Morgan Rodriguez gets the pitch in this one after all as he answers the call in the 15th inning.
Rodriguez.
Digging in, John Torres.
Leading off to St. Louis, the right fielder, John.
Here's the pitch.
Nope. Ball one.
Rodriguez, a native of Indiana, the Hoosier State. He's a veteran of 13 years at the major league level, which really points to the consistency he's shown since he first broke in.
Yeah, Matty, you ain't kidding right there. 10 years, we refer to that in the biz as hitting full potential.
Here comes the 1-0.
Cool, look there.
Well, you don't see that very often out of a rookie. That's a 2-0 count, and both of those pitches were really close. This guy has a pretty good eye.
Here it comes. And a good eye that time to lay off the fastball. It's 3-0. Here's the pitch.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
Shot toward right center. And this is going to get down for what should be extra bases. And there's your potential go-ahead run. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
Well, back in the day, you hope your leadoff man could go for a walk, or they got an infield single, but not in today's game. Now they expect the leadoff hitter to have a little pop, just like this guy. Nice leadoff double.
For ball one. Go ahead runs in scoring position here with nobody out. And he misses again, 2-0.
I don't know why in the world anybody would want to be an umpire. That manager has given this umpire an earful on a pitch that he thought was a strike, and he's certainly trying to defend his pitcher.
Rounded back up the middle. Taken in by Forsythe. And it's one away.
Now back to first baseman, Paul Goldsmith.
So digging in now, Paul Goldschmidt. And clearly this is a critical moment in this ball game. Go ahead, run at third with one away. Here's the first pitch. Curveball bounces here, but a good job behind the plate to keep it at arm's length. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with one away. Ball and strike. One ball and two strikes to count.
Down enough to come through, and that's exactly what he did.
And looking to improve on a 1-for-5 effort so far. He's set. Here's the 0-1. Fouled away. Here's the 0-2.
One ball, two strikes.
So the intent of that 0-2 cutter right there isn't necessarily to get a swinging strike. If you get it, well, hey, that's great. But if you get it inside enough and he does make contact, he probably can't do anything with it anyway.
Working for the punch out and the offering. Stays alive, still 2-2. Runner at second here with one man out. Liner towards second. There to take this one is the second baseman, and that's out number two.
Now batting. The shortstop.
Now at the plate, Paul DeJong. DeJong to add some padding to their lead in the form of that run standing out there at second base. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch.
0-1.
Trying to check it, and it's 0-1. He set the 0-1.
Cut
fastball, but that doesn't threaten the zone. It's even at 1.
Oh,
and he misses 2-1. Three balls and a strike to the Cardinals shortstop.
Good job to work the count and put himself back in the driver's seat. Started off with one strike, and now he's got the count in his favor, 3-1.
3-1, here it is. Swing and the ball hit foul as this will find the seats in right. Two out here and a runner at second. And he fouls this one off. Payoff pitch on its way. Hit the other way out toward right field. On the move is Harper. He can't get there, so the inning will continue. As he arrives at second without a play, as also on the play, a run comes across to score. Hector Neris enters from the pen now as they've saved their closer until this deep into extra innings.
Picking for the Phillies. Number four.
Quick now, Tyler O'Neill. Also take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. Trying to put it all behind him and break through right here. He's a paltry 0-6 thus far. Fouled off. Looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2. Fastball just misses. That's ball one. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time. To keep the deficit right where it is, the pitch. And he strikes him out here for out number three, but the damage has been done, as now they'll need some extra inning heroics to pull this one out. So it's two runs on three hits, no errors, and a runner left on. And now this crowd finds their club behind the eight ball here, as they don't want to wind up on the losing end of this thing. Cards lead it 8-6.
Way to go for the Phillies.
Now batting, Andrew McCutchen. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Hey, it's never easy scoring runs against a closer. But this lineup is setting up perfectly right now as the leadoff hitter leads off this inning.
The 1-0. Swing and a miss, strike one.
1-1.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Ball even at 2-2.
Yeah, well, down two, you better believe they'd gladly take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner on and get that tying run to the plate.
Swing and a miss, and that'll get a groan from the home supporters here. One away.
The batter number 10.
Ready now, Justin Turner comes into this appearance 1-for-6 on the ballgame. First pitch on its way. Hit on the ground after short.
two away now.
The right fielder, number three. Line. Harper.
So striding forward now, Bryce Harper. He was a ground-out victim last time up. Here's the pitch.
Nope.
You have to find a way in this situation to look in that on-deck circle and find a way to get your best hitter to the plate with a chance to tie.
There's a strike with the breaking ball.
Wow, I can't believe the hitter took that one. The pitcher absolutely got away with a hanger.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's one and two. Philly down to their last strike. And that one misses badly. It's ball two.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
Full count now. Now a swing, and he pops him up. And this should do it.
Goldschmidt is there.
Makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
It's times like these that I wish we were paid by the inning. The game seemed endless, but the fireworks in the top of the 15th were enough to decide it. And they hang on for the nice road win.
This one comes to a close today at an 8-6 final. Giovanni Gallegos earns the victory out of the bullpen, his fifth. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.